I want to bring in now Grover Norquist, president of Americans for Tax Reform. Okay, Grover, you just heard Rich talking about Cyprus, yes. And are you worried about taxes on our savings account here in America?
Look, we should always be worried. The advocates of ever-growing government are constantly on the lookout for new ways to tax, new things to tax, new ways to get their hands on assets. And as long as the Obama administration and the Democrats keep planning on spending $1 trillion more than they take in, they're always going to, whether it's a VAT or higher income taxes or more business taxes or going after people's 401ks and IRAs, as was done in Argentina, as has been discussed by some on the left in America. Yes, we should be concerned. I think the Republican House will stop it for the next 2 years, but we should be on the lookout.
All right, so it's Liz McDonald here, Grover. I mean, getting back to the tax on 401 savings accounts, we know that the Brookings Institute has entertained those ideas and has testified, officials there, and an academic has already testified about taxing 401ks, getting at that honeypot. But there was a backlash against that. Do you think it will come up again, and how many Congresses going forward?
It'll keep coming back about forever. Because the appetite for the people who want to spend other people's money knows no bounds. I mean, the drive to get government to take control of health care, which culminated in Obamacare, dates back at least to 1948. They kept coming, they kept coming. People Right. thought they'd won the argument, and it kept showing up. So we're going to be fighting this argument for 50 years against going after your 401k and trying to expropriate those resources.
Well, speaking of fighting this fight, you guys have really fought this fight more than anyone else. And last week, President Obama signed a new budget, the continuing resolution, whatever you want to call it. But either way, it was all cuts. There were no taxes. Are you taking a victory lap on that at all?
Well, I think the Republicans did exactly the right thing going back to 2011. No tax increases. We have to have $2.5 trillion in spending reduction from Obama's plans, and they're holding to that agreement. Obama tried to renegotiate it at least three times. Each time, the Republicans said no. So from now until October, it's all cuts, no tax increase, and that should continue moving forward.
So Grover, where's the next major battle going to be? Will it be the resumption of the sequester, or will it be the continuing resolution? Where's the next major battlefield in this going to be?
Well, there'll be efforts to try and talk the Republicans into negotiating on taxes, but the president has no leverage. In January, he made 85% of the Bush tax cuts permanent, so there are no more automatic tax increases as tax cuts lapse. So now the only way to raise taxes is to get the Republican House to vote for them. That isn't happening. We're going to have the continuing resolution, which takes us through to October, and then the caps come in, the legal caps on raise taxes. There'll be a fight on the debt ceiling, because Republicans might insist on more spending restraint, because Obama's going to have to come back and ask for a higher debt ceiling, because Obama and the Democrats in the Senate have just kept spending.
So that debt ceiling debate, the last time around, I think maybe the conventional wisdom was that the Republicans lost that battle. Not, you know, that gave a sequestration, but I think the aftermath of that, how do they get around it this time? Did they say, listen, we had sequestration, the world didn't fall apart, and the economy is getting better? Is that the tack they use, or do they, to your point, just say, listen, folks, you're getting taxed more and more, and this is what we've been warning you against?
Yeah, no. The Republicans won the fight in 2011. They said, you want to have a debt ceiling increase, you have to cut spending $2.5 trillion over.
I'm sorry, Grover. I don't mean that part of it. I meant the public relations aspect of it.
Yeah. Well, yes, the establishment press keeps telling you what a bad idea it is to have a budget deal that doesn't include a tax increase. That's true. That's a given. They always will. I think we just keep going back to the American people and saying our job is to protect you from their tax increases and from their overspending. And that's you never get to win that fight. You manage it, and you fight it every single day as long as the left keeps demanding more of other people's lives and income.
But without a doubt, you must feel so much better now than you did just a couple of months ago. The president's approval rating has been falling like a rock, in large part because a lot of people who were promised they wouldn't get a tax hike got a tax hike, the payroll tax hike, and a lot of people are seeing, to your point, that maybe, you know, it's not all about taxing, but we need to find ways to cut spending. So you must be feeling really a lot better now than you were just not too long ago.
Taxpayers are safer than they used to be. The president's made it clear he doesn't just want to tax the rich, he wants to tax everybody, and that he has no interest in any budget reform, any entitlement reform. And the good news is the Ryan budget plan actually reforms entitlements, reforms welfare along the lines of 1996, and does tax reform that doesn't increase taxes. So that budget balances the budget in the next decade without raising taxes. There is a model for success. The Republican House has passed it.
Right.
We now need to have a Senate and a president willing to accept yes for an answer.
Well, since the battle is going to go on forever, at least another 50 years, you look pretty robust. We think you'll be right out in front and center. Thanks a lot, Grover. Appreciate it.
Thank you.